Hey, welcome back to you. It is still Monday, giving you a double shot here today, following up the Work-Life Performance Edition earlier with this bit on parenting. I've been getting a lot of hot topics that I just feel like want to cover, and so I'm gonna throw the double shot at you today. Topic for today, burnout. Burnout. So traditionally, you get back into January, there's some enthusiasm. You've had a couple weeks to kind of take a break from the activities, whether that's the soccer team, the gymnastics, basketball, you know, you've been to dance class now for months and months. You had a time to take a break, and the kids got refreshed, and now they're coming back into it. But as you get towards the end of January, then that enthusiasm maybe starts to wane a little bit. Here's the key. You want to start to look for a couple of telling signs. Number one, the equipment that your son or daughter needs in order to be ready to go for that particular activity suddenly goes missing. This is a subtle cue to you. Your child is no longer thoroughly excited about being involved. Right? That disappearance is not by chance. That's their attempt to try and tell you, I need a little bit of time here. Okay? Something that's a little bit more explicit, a little bit more overt. I don't feel so well today. And all of a sudden, it was that recent onset of the stomach cramps before you got ready to go to practice. Some kids will tell you straight out, I need a break. But those kids are few and far between. Can't tell you the number of kids that I've coached in soccer that probably should have had a break sooner rather than later. Kids that played all the way through their youth, and when they finally got the opportunity at the end of high school to make a decision about whether or not they wanted to go on and play college ball, decided no, much to their parents' surprise after so many years. But these were kids that just for whatever reason didn't feel like they could tell their parents they needed to stop. Okay? And sometimes it's not stopping permanently, like at the end of the high school years, but sometimes it's just for 2-3 weeks. Just some time to get away, shift the focus, try something new. Okay? And that's what I'm advocating for you. If you get yourself into a situation where your child, at whatever age, starting to show the signs of burnout, take a break, 2-3 weeks, try something different, maybe the first couple days too. You're not doing anything. They're just doing nothing. It's best when your child comes back to you and says, all right, I'm bored. I need to get going again. Okay? And that might be, I need to get going again in whatever I was doing before. That maybe I just need to be active doing something. In which case, I'm going to suggest try something that is the complete opposite of what your child has been doing. They're actively engaged in sports. Find something in the arts. Okay? And vice versa. It works. The kids all of a sudden begin to explore something new and they get excited about just participating in an activity. Okay? So I'm going to throw those two ideas out at you. By all means, though, take a break when needed. Okay? Don't get caught up in the short-term thinking that I see a lot these days, which is if we take a break now, it'll hurt their future. They won't be able to continue on with the team, or they won't be able to continue on in this at this level. They will, and kids do it all the time. And in fact, the kids that excel at the highest level are the ones that did take breaks and did take some time off, and then they came back with renewed passion. So a little bit extra there for you. Hey, have a wonderful Monday. See you back here tomorrow. Take care.